and he is the one who saved me.
The Bible reading does enlighten Saye Zerbo's mind. It answers all of his questions. And in the pages of that Holy Bible, Saye discovers the mercy of a loving God. And so he keeps reading and studying and meditating on the Bible's deep and eternal truths.
Un samedi, quand la famille est venue de Touba, bon, il y avait mon garçon, il y avait 7 ans.
Once a week on Saturdays, my family was allowed to visit me. So they traveled all the way from Touga to Ouagadougou to see me. The first time my youngest son came to visit with the rest of the family, he was 7 years old. He was terrified because he had to walk through tanks in order to see me. So he asked me, "Daddy, how will you escape here?" I replied, "Don't worry, son. Even if this place is consumed with fire, I will be safe and I will get out." The guards who were surrounding me shook their heads with disbelief.
After more than 5 years, Saye Zerbo is finally released from prison and allowed to join his family in freedom.
Jesus was good to me. When I was subject to be killed, he delivered my physical body and saved my soul.
Saye Zerbo's religious conversion involved not only theology, but a personal change in behavior as well. A change so radical, it was seen immediately by those closest to his heart.
Most of the people who used to come home were Muslim, and they would take him out to places I didn't know, but surely not recommended for the head of the household. Those people are no longer coming, and I'm glad for that. The friend he has now are pastors and believers. If he's not out doing evangelism, he is home helping his grandchildren do their homework. It is a remarkable change for Jesus.
At the same time the Holy Spirit was drawing Saye Zerbo to Christianity, a similar experience was occurring in the life of one of his daughters. In fact, it was Medina Zerbo who was the first member of the family to become a Christian.
I had a schoolmate who was a Christian. One time in class, she talked to me about Jesus being a savior. And she asked me, "Don't you want to be saved?" I said to her, "What do you mean? Your God is the true one? Look, I'm a Muslim. I know Allah is the real God. But anyway, I think that God is the center and the religions are around converging to him." She tried to convince me of something different, but it didn't work. Then while playing with the niece, I was wounded on my leg. That wound didn't want to heal. There was a liquid flowing out of it. It was really hurting. So I went to the missionary center. Mrs. Nelson, a missionary, was there. She was very kind to me. She washed my leg with her hand with no gloves. I wouldn't want to touch it myself. She really touched me deeply by doing that. I continued to discuss with my friend at school, and she took me to her pastor. I accepted to go because that missionary was attending the same church. Mrs. Paré, the pastor's wife, prayed for me, and I asked her to pray for my father in prison. I had a joy that day. But I had hid myself while going to church because in the neighborhood, people were making fun of me going to church. I took the class for the baptism and was baptized. Those people from the church were visiting us. Every time they came and fellowshiped with us, it was an enjoyment. I noticed that those people were special. They were consistent in their visitation and their friendship. I knew I wanted to be a part of that Christian family.
Colonel Saye Zerbo joined his family. They too had seen in the miracle of Saye's transformed life the work of the Holy Spirit of God. They too had begun to read the Bible that had so captivated their husband and father. And they too embraced the greatest story ever told of how Jesus paid the penalty for their sins. The entire family now loved and served the Lord Jesus Christ.
I pass from darkness to light. God is God. What he did for us, we can't even explain it all.
The Bible refers to Jesus as the light of the world, but then it describes that Christians, men and women who are following God, are also lights of the world. We have an obligation to shine in the darkness. One of the ways that you have done this is writing two very provocative books. Could you give us a brief description of those two?
Le dialogue entre chrétiens et musulmans, je l'ai écrit, le voilà, je l'ai écrit en fonction de ce que la Bible.
I wrote the dialogue between Christian and Muslim according to what the Bible revealed to me. I felt that everything written in the Bible is the truth. Everything that God revealed to me comes to reality. From that point, I decided to do something to communicate the message to many people around me for them to come to the Lord. Explain to them the difference between what you can read in the Quran and in the Word of God. If you are a Muslim and want to correct yourself, you can do that under the light of the Bible. The Bible is the Word of God. Even Muhammad said that in the Quran, if you don't understand, go to those who have received the Word of God.